Hello you guys, I'm so excited for today's video because if you can't tell by the title, today I'm celebrating getting 100,000 subscribers and I literally am just so blown away by all the love and support you guys have given me throughout the years. Whether you've just watched one of my videos, liked a video, commented, just gave me support and encouragement, I just truly, truly from the bottom of my heart appreciate each and every single one of you. So today I thought it'd be fun to just celebrate because you have been a part of this as well to help me accomplish this amazing milestone. So today I thought I would unbox, if you are not aware. So YouTube gives an award, they're called play buttons, and they're basically a plaque of different subscriber amounts. So you get one when you reach 100,000, 1 million, and I believe it's like 10 million, I wanna say. So this has just definitely been a goal of mine and I'm just so happy to have reached it. And I just wanna quickly show you guys the moment, because I think I reached 100,000. I'm not filming this like right away. I waited like a couple weeks with everything that's been happening. It was a bittersweet moment for sure. But I did record myself when I like reacted to hitting the 100K mark. So I'll show you guys that right now. All right, you guys, I have my laptop here and I'm so excited because we are so close to 100,000 subscribers, which is just insane to me. This morning when I woke up, I checked and it was at 99.9 subscribers. My channel. Oh my gosh. It's at 100K. That is literally just so insane and so surreal to me. Like, oh my goodness. I can't believe that we're at 100K. It has just been such a journey and a lot of hours into this channel, and I am so blessed to have you guys as my community, because I've said this so many times to like my family, like I am blessed with like the best subscribers. Like, you guys just make my day. I read the comments and I just have the best subscribers. I notice you guys who are always commenting and supporting me, and it just means the world. Even if you don't comment, I know not always everyone comments and has the time. I'm just appreciative if you ever watch a video, like a video. It just makes my day that you even wanna take time out of your day to watch my content. So I appreciate you guys so much. All right, so now we are going to unbox this. I'm so excited. I already like pre-cut it, but I didn't open it or anything. I've been waiting to do a reaction on my channel. Oh my gosh, this is like so surreal. Oh my gosh. This is incredible. Let me show you guys. Oh my gosh. This is so amazing. So here's what it looks like. Well, there's a letter underneath. Okay, so there's a letter from the CEO of YouTube, Susan. Not sure how to pronounce the last name, but I will read this letter. You've just done something that very few YouTube creators accomplish. You had an astonishing 100,000 people subscribe to your channel. We know that numbers on YouTube can get really big, but we hope that you don't lose sight of the reality behind that six-digit milestone. Each and every person who has subscribed to your channel has been touched by what you created. They were inspired, challenged, or entertained. You achieved this milestone with hard work, perseverance, and probably a healthy sense of humor too. What you've accomplished can't be taken away from you, and we'd like to recognize you and all your hard work with the Silver Creator Award, a small token of our esteem and respect. We know that you don't do this for rewards. You do it because you have a drive to create and share, and because you found an audience who cares. Believe us when we say that we can't wait to see what you do next. A million subscribers may seem a long way off right now, but you're closer than you think, and we're rooting for you. Congratulations, yours sincerely. And then Susan from the CEO of YouTube. I started my YouTube channel to inspire others, and this has been such a journey, such an amazing journey. And like they said, it's not for the rewards, but it sure is nice to have goals in mind, and the fact that I get to inspire over 100,000 of you is just incredible. All right, so now I thought I would just do a little Q&A portion, and I'm gonna be doing a giveaway for you guys as well. So definitely stay tuned. So I'm gonna answer some questions that I asked you guys on both my Instagram stories, and if you're not already following on Instagram, I will have it listed here for you guys. But I have asked on Instagram stories and my community page, and I'm just combining all the questions. Some of them are repetitive, so I'm just gonna kind of answer for multiple questions at once. So the first one, I have them all here written out. So first is, what or who inspired you to have that fashion style slash taste? By the way, I enjoy watching your videos. Well, thank you so much. I have to say, I really wasn't influenced ever like with my girly pink style by anyone in particular. I have since a very, very young age been a very girly girl and just always loved pink and dressing up, and just there was never anyone that really influenced me. Although I mean, I have some fashion icons like Audrey Hepburn, I love Lauren Conrad, but I say just my taste has really just formed from just since I was little. I just always loved getting dressed up. Has always been a thing for me. So that's the first question. Next is, what is your favorite store to film try-ons for? So this is a good one. So of course I love every single store that I film a try-on haul for, but if I had to pick favorites, which is definitely a hard one, I would definitely say Nordstrom, just because I feel like they have such a good variety. I would say Walmart, because I think it's always fun to find an affordable find. And those are always just so much fun to do, and I know you guys love them too. And then I would also have to say Revolve. I don't share too much Revolve try-ons, but I really love Revolve clothing. And I also love doing H&M because they have such chic and gorgeous pieces, and their price points are so good. So yeah, I'd say those would pretty much round up my top favorites. Although, as I said, anything that I share on my channel is always going to be something that I love. So the next question is, what is my favorite thing about YouTube? Since I've always, as I said, loved fashion, really been into it, I've always been a creative person, I feel like. So I love that I get to create content with fashion, and it kind of combines two of my favorite things. So and then also just getting to connect with so many of you guys. Like, it just makes my day when I hear from you saying that you were inspired by something I shared, or you made you feel so great that you found a new beauty product. I mean, it just really makes my day, and that's one of the best parts as well. So this next question was definitely a commonly asked question. It was, YouTube your full-time job? So I'm actually glad I was asked this, because understandably, like, not a lot of people realize it is a lot of behind the scenes work that goes into it. So in short, it is my full-time job. I probably work, on average, it just depends on the week, but it's usually about 60 to 80 hours, especially around holiday time, 80 hours easily on my content. So I do work quite a bit, but I literally love it so much. It's like a dream job. This was another commonly asked question, and it was, anyone serious in your romantic life? Well, not right now. No one's serious in my life. I feel like when it's the right timing, even as fresh as it could be, the right guy just hasn't come along yet. But you know, I'm excited for when that happens. I've learned that just in the meantime, I'm trying to be the best version of myself and build my career. And in the meantime, whatever the right timing is when that guy comes along, like, I can't wait for it. So the next question is, congratulations, first of all, love your style. Thank you so much. What are your long-term goals? So I'll do career goals and then my personal goals. So career, I would definitely just love to continue. Sorry, the lighting's gonna go in and out. I definitely wanna continue, of course, growing my YouTube channel, but I do have some business goals that I'm not gonna share here. You'll just have to see them unfold, hopefully, you know, over the next few years. And again, for personal, again, I can't wait for the right man to come along in my life. And then also my Crohn's disease, I just hope long term I could get it in a better place than what it is right now, and what it has been for the past few years, unfortunately. So hopefully health wise and relationship wise, that would be like my long term goals. Next is, congratulations, so happy for you. Thank you so, so much. I watch your videos almost every single day, and sometimes I'll just rewatch them. That's so sweet. Love your videos. Any tips on how you plan out your videos? So I definitely have tried a lot of different planners and, you know, I don't know what to call it, like online planning, I guess, for, you know, content. I don't know how to say it. But I actually have had a lot of trial and error with this. I do love planners, like written planners, for like more like daily to-do lists and whatnot, and just things more set in stone. But because like my content sometimes, you know, a brand will sometimes reach out and say we have to switch this date, or I have to switch something because, you know, something came up and I have to switch around the content, I noticed that writing in a calendar, it was very hard because then things have to be scribbled out and it didn't look good. So I found Google Sheets is like lifesaver. You just make like a calendar in Google Sheets, and it is a game changer for me. Everyone's different with organization and everything like that and planning, but I plan out all sometimes up to 3 months in advance. So yeah, I really love Google Sheets for that. The next is congrats. Any tips on getting a cute Instagram theme? Thank you so much. Instagram themes are still something that I feel like I haven't perfected mine. I don't know if I ever will have like a perfectly curated Instagram feed or like profile. I feel like there's so many people on Instagram that have beautiful feeds, and then there are some people who also just have like just, you know, anything goes, which is great either way. I mean, everyone's audience and everyone's aesthetic is different. But for me, I'd say I'm kind of in the middle. Like sometimes I'll have like an aesthetic going and then like, I don't know. So, but I think the main thing is that if you have like a color scheme that you really like, me, blush, pink, and neutrals, I think it does tend to look more like a theme. But also like editing your photos, trying to use the same settings. I used to use presets, and you know, I just never found one that I was like obsessed with. So I just kind of do my own thing with every photo, but it's all kind of like the same to every photo. So I'll like adjust the brightness according to every photo. It's different, but then I'll adjust like the highlights on a photo or the shadows. I usually bump that up so to get rid of any like major shadows in a picture, because I like my photos a little bit more light and airy. And I also take out a lot of yellow in my photos, because a lot of times if I'm taking pictures of my apartment, they cast like, because the lighting, I think, yellow. So I try to definitely tone the yellow and pull out a lot of yellow so it looks very clean and white. That is like one of my favorite things to do to photos, to make them look a lot more dreamy. All right, let's do another one. Hi Karen, congratulations. I'm so happy for your YouTube success. I always enjoy watching your videos. You are so genuine and sweet. Like seriously, you're so sweet. Thank you so much. I have two questions for you. How are you keeping yourself busy during this time? And how has your health been recently? I hope you're doing well. Thank you so much. So I've actually been keeping pretty busy during this time with everything going on, which I'm very blessed to still be able to do all my work, and I've been staying busy with that. Really nothing has changed as far as like the amount of hours I've been working, so I stay pretty busy every single day pretty much with my work. So there's a lot of behind the scenes with what I do that most people don't know. So it's morning till night sometimes of just constant, you know, dedication and work, but it pays off, and I definitely I'm very, very blessed to have that. So, but how's my health been? But it definitely has been a little challenging, especially more than ever with my health and my autoimmune condition, Crohn's disease. It definitely has, you know, been harder. I've wanted to start my new medication for my Crohn's disease. I was supposed to start actually at the start of all this happening. I was supposed to start a new one, and I can't start a medication for my Crohn's, unfortunately. So I have been struggling for sure. So, you know, my heart goes out to anyone who has been dealing with the same thing. If you've been struggling, I'm praying for every single one of you guys, and I'm always here in my DMs if you ever need to chat. And my Crohn's, as far as that goes, I always try to keep it as positive as possible on here, but I mean, I do have my struggling days with my disease. Every single day I struggle. There's a lot of days that I struggle still in pain with my disease, so it can definitely be challenging, but you know, just taking it one step at a time, one day at a time, and that's really all you could do. So that's all I could really do at this point until I could get started on my new medication, and hopefully that's the answer for pain-free days. But in the meantime, yeah, just taking it one step at a time. Next question is, how do sponsorships work? So sponsorships usually start out where the brand will reach out to me, or if an agency, like a PR agency, will reach out to me, who is like the person, like the middleman, if you think of it. So there's the blogger, YouTuber, And then there's like the agency, and then there's the brand. So the agency is the one who communicates. So then the influencer doesn't talk directly to the brand sometimes, but sometimes it'll be, you know, a brand reaching out directly, which is great too. But I always take, of course, my partnerships very, very seriously. I can't imagine recommending something that I wouldn't, you know, want to share with, like, I imagine, say, my mom buying it out of her money, and I think, like, if it wasn't good, like, how would I feel if she didn't like it? You know, I always want to share things that I truly genuinely recommend. So just know that from my channel. Of course, this is just coming from my channel. I can't speak on everyone else's behalf, but for my content, whenever it's sponsored, you best believe I truly genuinely recommend it. Partnerships are super fun to do because, you know, there have been some brands at the top of my dream partnership list that I actually got to check off, which is so cool. So yeah, I really enjoy the partnerships too. Those are always fun. So I think that's also another great thing. But yeah, they work basically by them reaching out to you, and then there's a lot of back and forth, and sometimes you have to submit the content before you post it for approval, and then sometimes there's back and forth edits, like just minor things usually, and then there's like usually a contract in place before everything, so I have to read through the contract and make sure everything looks good. So those were pretty much the main questions. I got a ton of questions, so I'm so sorry if I didn't get to your question. I was trying to get through some of the most popular asked questions, so I hope you guys enjoyed that. And now for the giveaway portion, I just want to do something special for you guys. So you guys know that I love Elemis and I love Soul Society, so I actually reached out to the brands and they said they wanted to give back to you guys. So thank you to Elemis. They're going to be giving away 5 cleansing balms, my favorite cleansing balms like ever. I'm so excited. So 5 of you are going to win a cleansing balm, and then there will be 1 winner who will receive a $100 Soul Society gift card. Again, thank you to Soul Society and Elemis for supporting me as well. So I'm gonna make it super easy to enter. All you have to do is, of course, be subscribed to my channel, then like this video, and then you could also comment below as part of your entry. I'm trying to think of a good comment below. Oh, you guys could tell me how either you could answer one of these few questions. If you want to answer all of them, you're welcome to, but you could either tell me how you found out about my channel, like was it another YouTuber, or how did you find my channel, or when did you find my channel, like how long have you been subscribed, has it been recent, has it been for years? I'd love to hear. Or you could list, if you're not sure of the other questions, you could also let me know what type of videos you love most on my channel. Is it try-ons? Is it beauty? Like what, or what content you wanna see? So you could either answer 1, 2, or all 3 of the questions. And then you could leave your comments below, as I said. If you want a bonus entry, you could follow me on Instagram. I'll have my handle, as I said, here. And then just leave your Instagram username in your comment below too. I'll have all the giveaway details listed here as far as how long it's gonna run, and then all the winners will be listed in that description box. So yes, good luck to all those who enter. Again, I just wanted to give back to you guys. I really appreciate you, and yeah, good luck to all those who enter. You guys are just the best. So I hope you guys enjoy this video. I just really enjoy filming it and just sitting down and chatting with you guys, and hopefully you got to learn a little bit more about me. And yeah, that's gonna be it for today's video. I love you guys so much, and I will see you all in my next one very soon. Bye.